the Gender Mainstreaming Evaluation Framework.
Chapter 4, GMEF Entry Points. Let's discuss the four entry points to ensure gender mainstreaming in an organization. First is policies. It refers to the official statements and pronouncements of support for gender mainstreaming issued by the organization. Through these issuances, the organization shows its recognition and acceptance of gender equality goal as a critical and legitimate concern in broad or general terms. Remember, use of gender-fair language and images in GAD-related policies and plans is a must for a gender-responsive organization. Second is people. Mainstreaming gender and development is not possible without people supporting and advocating for it, right? So who are these people? Critical to the success of gender mainstreaming are the GAD champions among top management. The organization should also establish a GAD focal point system that will lead its gender mainstreaming efforts and will serve as GAD experts. The organization must also ensure that its internal and external clients are able to participate in the planning, implementation, and monitoring and evaluation of GAD programs, activities, and projects. Yes, GAD is a participatory process. The third entry point is the enabling mechanisms. What will ensure that gender mainstreaming will be operationalized in an organization? The success of any gender mainstreaming effort depends, to a large extent, on the resources allocated and the mechanisms that are institutionalized to implement it. Some examples of enabling mechanisms include the functionality of the GAD focal point system, presence and use of knowledge management system and GAD database, and partnership building or external linkages with other organizations to implement GAD programs. This entry point should also look into the institutional compliance to the minimum 5% allocation and utilization of GAD budget of the organization. And lastly, the programs, activities, and projects, or PAPs. This refers to flagship programs, activities, and projects that serve as a strategic entry point to mainstream gender perspective in the organization. PAPs is the most practical entry point, since it involves the actual implementation of the mandate of an organization. Organizations may apply gender analysis tools such as the Harmonized Gender and Development Guidelines to assess gender-responsive mainstreaming through PAPs. Examples of PAPs are contained in the Program Expenditure Classification Outcomes and Strategic Plans of the organization.